Hello, and welcome to Software Architecture Monday. My name is Mark Richards. I'm a hands-on software architect and also the founder of developer2architect.com. In the previous lesson, number 49, we saw kind of an introduction about what is enterprise architecture. In this lesson, lesson 50, we're going to review one of the two approaches of the traditional approaches of enterprise architecture, the model-driven approach. When we think about the model-driven approach to enterprise architecture, this is the approach we generally use, one of the traditional approaches of enterprise architecture, to really determine how to do a particular initiative, those kind of initiatives we saw in the prior lesson. So the very first step in this model-driven approach is really to say, what do we currently have? In other words, this involves that enterprise architecture modeling effort to say, before we do anything, let us get a picture of our landscape. Then we ask, what would you like to do? In other words, now we can do an initiative because we have a current state and a complete model of what we really have. Now, what do you want to do? And from there, now we develop a roadmap. And so notice this kind of pathway so far where we do modeling. Now we have an initiative. And those roadmaps say, how do we get there? By combining what we need to do with what we currently have. And then the next step, the final step, is really always saying, what is our progress? And this is that whole enterprise communication aspect. Now, something else happens in the model-driven approach, because that enterprise communication really then goes all the way back to saying, what do we currently have? Because at each stage, at each iteration of that initiative, once we complete something, that changes what we currently have. And this cycle just continues all the way through. Now, if we analyze the model-driven approach, this really is kind of like, I'd like to term this, model first, then ask questions later. Because what we do first in the model-driven approach of EA is to ensure that we have a complete picture of our IT systems, our infrastructure, our business workflows before we take anything on. And as a matter of fact, some of the advantages here is that we do have a complete view of that enterprise. It's fairly well documented. And also, because we are documenting first, this does allow for bottom-up and top-down identification of initiatives. You see, because we're modeling, during that modeling phase or that exercise or that practice, we can start to see inefficiencies ourselves that the business may not see. And so this does allow for that bottoms up and top down as well. However, there are two real big negatives about the model-driven approach of the traditional approaches of EA. First of all, that modeling effort usually takes way too long. That first step there in that enterprise architecture modeling, what do we have? Never, ever seems to stop. And correspondingly, those models rarely reflect the true current state of the enterprise because it takes too long. It's always changing. Linked with the model-driven approach really is where we start to get to that Zachman framework. In other words, when we take a look at some of those architectural frameworks, the Zachman framework of enterprise architecture really fits well with this model-driven approach. And when we take a look at the Zachman model, right here, what we're really doing is focusing on modeling the enterprise. There's not much here about how to do things, but we have fairly complete models. And within these kind of grids within Zachman, horizontally, he has perspectives. And so we start way down at the technical perspective, move up to the engineering perspective. This would be the application teams, the architect perspective, finally up to the business, and then all the way up to the executive perspective. And these perspectives are really cool because from an engineering perspective, being, let's say, a developer, I need to know very specific details. Whereas from the architecture view, I really don't need to know those many details. I need to know how things fit together. So I really like, actually, the way this is organized from a documenting or modeling standpoint. And then, of course, the models across perspectives, we have models. And they're the six core questions of human nature. What, how, where, who, when, and why. And so, for example, we may be able to go down through the why model, which is my favorite model, by the way, in Zachman. That's the motivation model. So go down the model over to the architect perspective. And that gives us kind of a justification to say why, for example, are we moving to microservices? And I'm able to justify that usually based on some sort of business concept or perspective, which then leads up to the executive perspective. And so this is a nice way of kind of framing the modeling when you're doing model-driven approach to enterprise architecture. Now, in the next lesson, we're going to take a look at the second kind of traditional approach to enterprise architecture, which is really that initiative-driven approach. But please go to Software Architecture Monday at my website to get all these lessons in software architecture. And also, you can see where I'm at for public events, online training, public conferences, even public training, by going to my website under Upcoming Events. And so this has been Software Architecture Monday, Lesson 50, The Model-Driven Approach to Enterprise Architecture. Stay tuned next week for Lesson 51, well, we'll take a look at a contrasting approach, which is the traditional iterative-driven or initiative-driven approach to enterprise architecture. And then we're going to wrap all this up in Lesson 52 the following Monday by actually taking a look at why these approaches fail and take a look at some new modern approaches to enterprise architecture. So this has been Software Architecture Monday. Again, my name is Mark Richards. Thank you so much for listening, and stay tuned next week for the next enterprise architecture lesson, which is the initiative-driven approach. Thank you.